Let's talk a little bit about fat grafting or fat transfer procedures. It's really important to understand with fat grafting or fat transfer procedures that the technology is important to the quality of the outcome. Why is that? Well, we know that fat cells are very sensitive to different things in their environment. Number one is shear stress. Fat cells don't do well when they're subjected to great force or to great pressure. That's one of the reasons why we tell patients not to sit after a Brazilian butt lift or a surgery where they've had fat transfer to the buttocks and to reduce pressure to the breasts after a breast fat transfer. So what are the things that we can do with regards to technology to improve the outcome of the fat transfer procedure? Well, the first thing is really important. That's regarding how we harvest the fat, how we take it out of the body. We utilize the power-assisted liposuction cannula with a very special tip that's a large basket cannula in order to help remove the fat without subjecting it to a large amount of trauma as it's leaving the body. I then utilize a state-of-the-art fat transfer system. It's called a Wells-Johnson system, but it's essentially a closed canister, okay? A closed canister that is completely sterile and isn't open to the outside world. Tubing from the liposuction cannula and handpiece goes into this closed canister where the fat accumulates after I remove it from your body. It sits on top of a vibrating pedestal so that the fat rises and fluid goes to the bottom of this canister. I then remove the fluid from the bottom so that we're left with high quality fat in a sterile, completely closed environment. Next, this system has another set of tubing that goes off of the system, and that tubing is connected to a special pump. The pump senses the pressure of the fat as it's going back into the body. This is absolutely critical because it reduces the amount of pressure that we generate as we're putting the fat back in. This helps to, most importantly, preserve the quality of the survival of the fat cells as they go back in. It may also reduce the risk of things like fat embolism or too much pressure on the fat cells so that they're not injected in an area where they are going to potentially have fat necrosis or fat oil necrosis later on. So it goes through that pump and then it's actually put back into the body, and I utilize the same vibrating handpiece. Why is that? Well, because the vibrating cannula that goes back into the body gently helps to vibrate the fat into place where we want it. It's much better than utilizing a syringe. A syringe, when you inject fat, goes through a cannula and it generates a tremendous amount of pressure. Syringes can generate around 760 millimeters of mercury, which is high pressure to put the fat back in. This system generates around 11 to 13 millimeters of mercury, which is a much lower pressure to allow the fat cells to go back into the body without being subject to those shear forces that can lead to the loss of survival of fat. The other thing is that if it's gently being vibrated in, the fat doesn't create a clump. Like with a syringe, when you inject, it can create a clump of fat or an area where fat is essentially like in the shape of a ball. And the fat on the inside doesn't receive oxygen delivery from the tissues around it as easily, and that leads to fat necrosis. So gently vibrating the fat in with a vibrating handpiece helps to improve the quality of survival of the fat in that regard as well. These technologies are all very important for assuring the best quality of fat transfer and take, and for safety as well, to reduce the risk of these other complications like fat necrosis and death of those fat cells. Now, there's other things that are important in the technology of fat transfer. One of them is the use of hyperbaric oxygen chamber treatment afterwards, because those fat cells, once they've been transplanted, cry out for oxygen, and they do that by secreting inflammatory factors. If we give them the oxygen they need, then they survive better, inflammation and swelling goes down because those factors are reduced, and the oxygen helps to remove secondary metabolites of anesthesia, so you feel better after the surgical procedure. This is absolutely critical to the survival of those fat cells after they've been transplanted, and it's one of the best ways to ensure the quality of your result and to protect the quality of your result and your investment after surgery. There are a few other things that I do with regards to fat transfer that improve the quality of survival of the fat, and those include special medications that I utilize at the time of the harvest of the fat, injected medications that I use during a liposuction procedure, and medications that I add to the fat after it's been harvested to improve their survival. And we'll talk about those again during the consult and in person. These are all scientifically backed interventions that have had good clinical studies that show that they do improve the quality of fat transfer and harvest. The other thing that's important to understand is that, you know, it's not just about where we put the fat, it's also about where we take it from and the quality of the healing in those areas. These injectable medications help to reduce bruising and swelling in those areas to give you the best possible result in the liposuction areas over time. So fat grafting and fat transfer, they really are a technology-based surgical procedure. And it's important to understand what I do, the technologies that I use, and how they're different, and how they improve the quality of the fat transfer and improve the quality of the surgical results over time.